everyone, my name is Chanel, otherwise known as Tiny Tattooer. If you're familiar with my work, you've probably noticed that I love to paint on wooden plaques. Aside from skin, it's easily one of my favorite canvases to work with. If you yourself have ever worked with these pre-cut wooden plaques you normally find at the craft stores like Michael's or even Walmart sometimes, I'm sure that you're no stranger to the annoying, chunky, hairy bits usually surrounding the borders and edges of everything. So today, I'm going to be sharing with you how I personally go about prepping my plaques, smoothing out the surfaces, getting rid of that ugly hair, and how I map out my sketches before getting into a painting. So the materials you're going to need are a wooden plaque, sandpaper, gesso, big brush, a pencil, scissors, tape. Transfer paper is optional, and so is ruler or measuring tape if you got some. So once you've removed any wrapping or stickers that might be found on your plaque, now is the time to get started on sanding. So what I normally like to do with the sandpaper is just tear off a tiny little corner, one that you can fold a couple times. This is going to help to get in all the crevices, all the corners that you probably won't be able to do with like a larger sheet. So this part of the process is pretty much self-explanatory. I usually go about sanding with as much vigor and as quickly as possible, just to get it out of the way. It's definitely not the most fun part of the process, but in my opinion, this part is the most essential. So now it's time to coat the plaque in gesso. And for anyone who has not worked with gesso before, it's essentially just a thicker kind of acrylic paint. And its purpose is to fill in any craters or any bumps that might be in your canvas, or in this case, a wooden plaque. Using a brush, you're going to want to apply the gesso evenly all over the surface of the plaque. Wait for each layer to dry completely before applying a new layer. Personally, I like to apply up to 4 layers before mapping out my painting. So sometimes after applying the gesso, I realize that I overlook some lumps and bumps and might still be a little bit grainy around the edges. So at this point, I take the opportunity to just go back in real quick with sandpaper, and with enough layers of gesso, you don't have to worry about it exposing your plaque. Once the gesso is all dry, we're ready to map out the design. Now this part is really up to personal preference. Some people like to just sketch straight onto the canvas, some people like to sketch with their paintbrush. I personally like to plan everything out in advance. I usually either achieve this by sketching out to size on a separate piece of paper, or by using my iPad to size out the image more accurately. From there, I cut out the image, trying to stay as close as possible to the perimeters of the image. Then I layer my design on top of some transfer paper, and I cut around that as well. Now for those of you who are unfamiliar with charcoal transfer paper, just make sure that your shiny side is not the part that you are attempting to transfer. Just make sure that the more coarse, charcoal-y part is the one that's facing downward on your surface before you get started. From there, I place my charcoal paper and sketch down on my plaque, and I proceed to transfer using a pencil. And now you're ready to start on your painting. I hope some of these tips can be useful for you in your future projects. You can find Amazon links to each of the materials used here in the description below. If you've made it this far, thanks so much for watching, and I'd love to read your feedback and ideas for future videos in the comments. Take care.